Today we meet for part two of doing business in Canada. Last week we had covered part one on understanding how the various incorporations in different states work out, and today we're going to do a little more in detail of understanding how businesses can operate own properties and tax rates in Canada and so on. So first we'll start with registering property, building warehouse and trading across borders and trademarks in Canada. So Canada welcomes buyers from across the globe, and there are no restrictions on the type of properties which can be purchased. And the steps and time involved in registering properties, assuming a standardized case of an entrepreneur who wants to purchase land and building that's already registered and free of any title dispute, it's a close to 10 days affair for him to complete the entire registration formalities of a land or an existing building. So the brief steps involved will be to obtain a tax clearance and a utility clearance certificate from the municipality, which takes about 2 days. Obtaining a copy of parcel register and search for writs, obtain a status certificate for the selling corporation and conduct a title search to ensure that there's no encumbrances on this title and the title is free of lien, registration of the transfer of title, which takes a day. So in close to about 8 to 10 days, a property can be registered in Canada. And building a warehouse on a land, if there is no existing building already on the land, it takes close to about 3 to 6 months to obtain the permissions and to get the procedures started. Preliminary project review with municipality authority has to be done, where the municipality authority ensures that there is no deviation in terms of the planning permit and zoning permit, which is required for them to get started with the project, which takes about 30 days. So step 1 and 2 can be done simultaneously. So in a period of 30 days, the preliminary project review with the municipality authority along with obtaining an application for zonal permit is achieved. The site plan and approval from municipality authority can take anywhere between 3 to 6 months. But generally the time frame is, you know, when all the documents are in order, it can complete maximum in the period of 3 months, which is 90 days. And building permit is issued once point 1 and 2 and 3 are completely satisfied, and a building permit is issued in 15 days. And on every scale or levels of construction, there is an inspection. So there's an inspection of foundation, inspection of frame, drainage inspection, sanitation and plumbing inspection. Each inspection can take, depending on the degree of construction, anywhere close to 1 to 5 days. And once these inspections are completed, the next step will be to obtain the water and sewer service connection, which can take about 14 working days, and a fire department inspection from the civil defense. And last but not the least, a final inspection and occupation permit is issued. So for the purpose of the cost involved, a 300 square meter or a 3000, roughly 3000 square feet of a building warehouse can cost anywhere between 60,000 Canadian dollars to 150,000 Canadian dollars, depending on the structural requirement that a building requires. In terms of trademarks, Canadian companies enjoy a trademark and ease of trademark registration as well. As we know, a trademark is a sign or combination of sign used or proposed to be used by a person to distinguish their goods from others. An application for trademark registration may be made to the Canadian Intellectual Property Office, and there is a fees involved of 330 Canadian dollars. After application, the mark shall be reviewed by the CIPO office, following which the trademark will be published in a trademark journal to allow for public opposition. So once that advertisement or a publication is involved and there is no opposition from the public, then it's fine. But if anyone opposes the published trademark, a trademark agent can be hired to solve the opposition by appealing to the Federal Court of Canada and reaching a decision. In the case of no opposition, or if an opposition has been decided in the favor of the company, the registrar will register the application and will not look for any further challenges. And the registered trademark is valid for usage in Canada for a period of 10 years, after which there is a renewal charge of 400 Canadian dollars which has to be paid. And a subsequent period of 10 years will be issued to the company. So it's a very simple and straightforward process, and like many other countries in the world, Canada helps in trademark registration and helps companies to maintain the goodwill or the intellectual properties in terms of trademarks and its registration as well. So thinking about trading across borders, how easy is import and export in Canada? It's in record times is what has been understood in our study. The cost and time related are given below, where the exports takes about 2.5-3 hours maximum for clearance and inspection by customs authorities, and every export bill will cost about 167 Canadian dollar, US dollars. And port handling generally takes about half an hour. Clearance and inspection required by customs authority for imports is close to about 2 to 3 hours, and that costs about $150. And port or other port handling for import costs takes about half an hour time. So it's, you know, record time compared to many other countries or developed countries in the world. Understanding the tax law and applicable tax rates. First, let's look at the federal tax rate and the different territorial tax rates. So as you can see, the territorial tax rates ranges from Alberta to Newfoundland and Labrador from 10 to 15%. So this is the range it works. And the federal tax rate is 15%, a slab rate figure. Small businesses which are operating under a CCPC, which is controlled by Canadian resident companies, here the tax rates vary, and this can be only owned by a Canadian resident and cannot be owned directly or indirectly by public corporation or non-residents. So only for Canadian residents and the 100% controlled companies by Canadian resident get this benefits of a lower tax rate. And the business limit for income is 500,000, and in the case of Saskatchewan, it's 600,000. But every other jurisdiction is 500,000. So in excess of 500,000 of business income, the tax rate applies to the active businesses. Capital gain tax is on gains realized on the transfer of ownership. So it could be sale, exchange, transfer, distribution, cancel, redeem, destroy, loss, expire, expropriate, or surrender of a capital asset. And capital gain is calculated as the difference between the consideration received and, of course, the cost of the asset at the time of realization, subject to indexation. And the capital gain tax is at the rate of a whopping 50% in Canada. And looking at indirect taxes, generally the Federal Goods and Services Tax, which is GST, applies to all taxable goods and services supplied in Canada. There is also a harmonized sales tax scheme, which is a blended between the provisional and the federal sales tax. And it's 5% is a GST in Alberta and few other territories, 13% in Ontario, which has a HST harmonized tax system, and 15% in few of the other territories. Withholding tax for non-residents. The types of income which fall under 25% withholding categories are dividends, interest, royalties, technical service fees, rent, and management fees. However, if there is a tax treaty in the form of DTA, Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement, between Canada and the country of residence of the non-resident, the terms of the treaty may reduce the rate of non-withholding or non-residence tax to be withheld. Understanding some basic statistics in Canada, if you look at the GDP, there has been a sustainable moderate plus and minus in GDP between 2008 to 18. 19 has been a good year, but we have not been able to capture the actual numbers. And 20, as we all know, we are going to look at a dip globally because of the ongoing COVID issues. Tax to GDP ratio, it had been slightly poorer between the years 2008 to 14, but after that, with the good tax collection measures, the tax to GDP ratio has gone close to about 12.8% and above in 2018. And Canada, if you look into it, between importing and exporting nature, it's predominantly an importer, where the imports are always more than exports, and that basically lets you into a trade deficit over the period of time, except for in 2014. But overall, that there has been a massive trade deficit in Canada. Foreign direct inflows or direct investment has been good between 13 to 15, and it has dipped down. 16 and 17 and 18 has been good in terms of FDI, foreign direct inflow of $46,543 million into Canada. And Canada is also implementing various residency scheme and citizenship scheme to encourage people to come and settle down in Canada, subject to satisfying multiple conditions, and that is also helping it boost its foreign direct investment into Canada. So thank you very much for listening to our presentation. We look forward to meeting you with yet another interesting presentation next week. Have a nice day. Stay safe. Stay indoors.